สวัสดีครับ
สวัสดีค่ะ
Hello everyone. Today we would like to present about the science project. The title of the species of mosquito larvae and water quality in shrimp pond, Trang Province, Thailand. My name is Anop Sakamani.
My name is Pramohat Pumia. We are the student from Princess Jurapporn Zion High School Drive.
Plang, why do we do this project?
It is very important to do this project because mosquito borne disease is one of the major factors, the major problems that become the global issues. And the disease about West Nile virus, malaria, dengue fever, and yellow fever has transmitted mainly in the tropical and subtropical area, and in our hometown, Thailand, was one of the risk areas too. And from our study, container may be the important factor to be the breeding site of the mosquito larvae. Shrimp farming are one of the important carriers to the local community. There are about 1,000 farms for the shrimp farm in Trang Province. In each farm, there are a big forest that can probably be the breeding site of mosquito larvae. And from our previous study, we have a chance to talk with the local people. They told us that the dengue fever in that area may be because of the mosquito in the shrimp farms. So we need to prove it. And this is the reason why we need to do this project. And this is about the research questions. First, what are the type and the number of mosquito larvae in the shrimp farms? And second, do water qualities affect the type and the number of mosquito larvae in shrimp farms? And the last one is, what are the different type of mosquito larvae in shrimp farms and in the house around the shrimp farms? Our hypothesis, first, type of mosquito larvae in shrimp farms are at least two species. Second, water quality affects the species and the number of mosquito larvae. Third, the species of mosquito larvae in shrimp pond and in the house around the shrimp ponds will not have significant difference. And our larval survey was conducted in Trang Province, the southern of Thailand, in February 2018. And this map showed the study site. We collect the larval, we collect the mosquito larvae in three sub-districts in Yantahao, Balian, and Hasamra. We have collected the data about mosquito occurrence site condition in 31 shrimp farms and about 25 households. And on this picture, the green one represents the house that we collect the data, and the yellow pink is mean the shrimp farms.
Wow, how do we do this project?
And this is about our methodology. First, we find the study area that has the shrimp farms. We sample the mosquito larvae in the shrimp farm by dipping the bed into the surface of water. After that, we measure the quality immediately and collect the data about current site condition. We went to collect mosquito larvae in the house around the shrimp farms for both indoor and outdoor containers. After that, we identify the mosquito larvae up to species. And then we input the data on the globe website. We input data for analysis in Microsoft Excel and analysis all of the data in SPSS program. After we finish all of our results, we return back our results to the local community. How about our results?
This is our result. Look at the table. The table tells me about the numbers of mosquito larvae in shrimp ponds. We collect the data for 31 shrimp ponds, but only have the 9 shrimp ponds that found the mosquito larvae, and all of the mosquito larvae that we found are the Culex species. And this graph shows me about the number of Culex species larvae in shrimp ponds. And look at the graph. You see that 9 ponds that we found the mosquito larvae there are no significant difference in each pond. And this table shows me about the water quality in shrimp ponds between shrimp ponds with mosquito larvae and without mosquito larvae. And we collect the data about pH, salinity, conductivity, temperature, and DO. And we found that they have two factors that significant difference between shrimp ponds with mosquito larvae and without mosquito larvae. And this table shows me about the relationship between number of Culex species, mosquito larvae, and water quality of shrimp ponds for mosquito larvae. And we found that salinity, conductivity, temperature are affects the number of Culex species in shrimp ponds.
How about the mosquito larvae that fall in the household near the shrimp ponds?
We found the four species. The most number of mosquito larvae is a Culex species, and followed by Aedes, Albopicta, Aedes, Aegypti, and Toxolynchaeus species. This is our conclusion. First, in shrimp ponds are only Culex species mosquito larvae, and the number of mosquito larvae was positive correlation with salinity, conductivity, temperature, but not correlated with pH and DO. And households near shrimp ponds were the breeding sites of Aedes aegypti, Aedes albopicta, Culex species, and Toxolynchaeus species. And if we found only Culex species mosquito larvae in shrimp ponds, it means the dengue fever is not come from the shrimp ponds, but come from the household near the shrimp ponds.
So we can prove that dengue fever is not come from the shrimp ponds.
Why there are lots of mosquito larvae in shrimp ponds?
There are lots of mosquito maybe because of the way to do the shrimp pond by a local farmer. And here is the example how did they do the shrimp ponds. First, they put some chemical substance into the water to get rid of the living things, so everything in the pond will dead. After that, they will wait for a week. Then, if he saw the mosquito larvae appear in the surface of water, it means that the water is safe enough to put some new generation of the shrimp inside it. And then the shrimp will eat the mosquito larvae as a food, and the local farmer can save the money to buy the food for the shrimp. After we finish our project, we return our result back to our local community to tell them that dengue fever is not come from the shrimp ponds, but it has the source at the breeding site around the house.
Wow, what we learn more about our project?
From doing this project, we learn a lot of things, but the wonderful experience that we can have a chance to work in group and can come together with the local people to solve the local problems. And we have the cooperation with the scientists in the program that help us to solve the local problem together. And we are just a small part of the world to take care of our local environment. If every part in the world come together, it will have a big impact to develop our environmental of the world. We would like to thank all of the persons that support us to doing this project.
Thank you.